Good morning, dear hearts. We are in lesson 28. Do you realize we're coming close to the end of our first month of lessons? Anyway, please subscribe. So today's lesson, obviously, as I mentioned yesterday, was going to be an expansion continuation from yesterday, just as lesson 21 was to lesson 20. I'm determined to see differently. Above all else, I want to see differently. We are making commitments here. Now, as it says, it's a definite commitment. But then it says the question is whether or not in the future you might keep it. But you know what? It's okay. That's not the concern right now. It says if you are willing at least to make these commitments now to see differently, then you've started on the way to keeping them, and we are still at the beginning. So it's really just for today. Don't have to worry about it except just for today. The lesson goes on to say, you may wonder why it's important to say, for example, above all else, I want to see this table differently. Now, you might remember that in lesson 7, which was, I see only the past, this lesson is actually linking into that as well as 20, 21, and 27. And there's a little bit of 25 in here as well. In lesson 7, it was that whole thing about the cup, okay, that I see only the past. So I see the past in this cup. My experience of the cup is only based on my past experience of other cups. Today, it's a table. So we've gone from a cup to the table. And it says, above all else, I want to see this table differently. And in and of itself is not important. And what does in itself mean? It goes on to say, you see a lot of separate things about you, which really means that you are not seeing at all. This is that subtle awareness. You know, we've talked about overt and covert. This is very covert. As we see separate things around us, it means we're not really seeing, because we are seeing separation, and what we truly see with vision is union, that all is one. And then this lesson says you either see or not. Very Yoda, do or do not, there is no try. You see or you see not, there is no try. But it tells us that when we have had the experience, it doesn't say experience, but when we've had the experience of seeing one thing, just one thing differently, then you're going to see all things. We will see all things differently. It says the light you will see in any one of them is the same light you will see in all of them. Again, as yesterday I mentioned the little light edges from lesson 15, it is the light within every object we see, everything we see, every person we see. There is nothing but union in truth. And if I'm seeing separately, this is over here, that's over there, I'm not seeing union. I'm seeing separation. And with that, I will not acquire vision. Above all else, I want to see things differently. I want to see the oneness in all. Paragraph 3 says, when you say above all else, I want to see this table differently, you are making a commitment to withdraw your preconceived ideas about the table. Back to lesson 7 and this cup, and my preconceived notions and ideas about the cup. Because otherwise I'm defining it on past terms, and you are asking what it is rather than telling it what it is. That's the difference. Tell me what you are rather than me telling you. Because if I'm telling you, I've made up all the meaning that you have for me, and none of that is true, because I'm working out of my ego mind. It tells us you are not binding its meaning to your tiny experience of tables, nor are you limiting its purpose to your little personal thoughts. Lesson 25, purpose is meaning. The purpose of this table is the meaning of this table. And the meaning of everything is for joining. The meaning of everything is to heal the separation. The meaning of everything is in our own best interest. There's a wonderful line in paragraph 5 that says, you could in fact gain vision from just the table if you would withdraw all your own ideas from it and look upon it with a completely open mind. Because that table, when I see it as the having the meaning of the universe, it says it shares, its purpose is shared with all of the universe. There's no separation. There's no, this has one meaning, that has another. All things join for our good. And when we see the purpose in the table, we see the purpose in the universe. The purpose of everything is being revealed to us. The practicing is 6 times again, 2 minutes, looking around the room and let your eyes light upon whatever it happens to be and say, above all else, I want to see this, fill in the blank, differently. I want to see this pen differently. I want to see this table differently. I want to see this hand differently. I want to see myself differently. That is all we are here to do, to see everything differently and the true meaning of it. That's it for today. Please like, please share, please subscribe, please comment, please pray, and please be here tomorrow for a favorite lesson. Namaste.